I need to know why.
There are so many things no one has the answers for.
What does that mean?
Why we lose the people we love? Death? Pain? Change? Sadly, it's all a part of life. You're trying to figure out if there's something you could have done to stop this. We'll never know why people elect to take away the blessing of life. There is nothing you could have done. We all have our time. Unfortunately, she decided to make that decision on her own.
She loved me.
Try to remember her as she was. A loving mother. A human being. I will pray for her soul, young man.
I'll take it from here, Fiona.
Something sad. So sorry, Annie.
No. It's beautiful. I think I may have found somebody.
One?
I'm sorry, but this is the least expensive casket that we have.
I think we're gonna have to go to the cremation services down the mountain. A casket and burial is out of our price range.
So your mother grew up around here, right? Excuse me, why don't I speak with my associate and see what we can do?
Mother?
Yes.
Then that's him.
He's cute. I'll see what I can do about having him come over for dinner. That is, if you're sure. Excuse me. Why don't we go with this one?
I'm sorry. What?
Providing for a loved one's death can be very hard. Especially when it comes up so suddenly. And you're all alone, so why don't we just write off the whole thing to a small local discount?
Thank you, but that's too much.
Nonsense. You mentioned that you lived around here. I mean, you're just practically family.
I couldn't.
You can.
What I meant to say was that I couldn't accept such a generous offer without giving you something in return.
Dinner, then. Why don't you come and have dinner with myself and my family?
Thank you.
Oh, no. No buts. You shouldn't be alone.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. His mother dying and practically dropping on our doorstep is just too perfect. Of course. But even tragedy has its happy coincidences.
Yeah. I guess so.
What are you doing?
Trying to help. You know your mother would have looked pretty in a burlap sack. I found some jewelry your mother borrowed from me before you were born.
Aunt Jenny, please.
I didn't come here to take it, Brandon.
Why did you come here?
Because we're family. That's what family does. Your mother chose to push us away. That doesn't mean you have to.
You're the only one who came to the funeral.
The only one who cared to. Who would choose a family like that?
Did anyone ever tell you you look just like your father?
No.
Well, you do. The rest is pure Eleanor.
You're looking fair.
Did you ever love Lassiter?
Maybe.
Sometimes I think we love the song or the gift more than we ever did each other.
I never noticed. I guess I chose not to.
Not like you and John.
And still, John threw the song away.
Yes, but not you.
Didn't he?
True love, even with time on our side, is always an uphill battle. Some of us are born to love, and some of us maybe not.
Why did you do it, Kat? Sing the song with Lassiter.
For you.
I never would have asked.
No, I'm happiest watching you in love. First with John, and now, really, I'm happiest being a spectator. Hey, I was never meant to be with a man. They're way too fragile. Fiona, really, I'm happy being here for you. Oh, Fiona. Hold on, let me look at you. Okay, last touch.
Hey, I'm Fiona.
Brandon.
It's nice to meet you, Brandon. And you brought wine. How sweet.
Yeah, you know, I figured I should bring something to the table. So.
Oh, thank you, but you've already brought plenty. And I should let you in my house. Where are my manners? I'm so sorry, please. Don't come in.
It's fine.
Katarina's my sister. She's the one who sold you the coffin.
I don't know if sold is the right word.
You know what I mean. Showed it to you.
I know. That was a joke.
Oh. We try to help out when we can. The funeral business is kind of more of a family tradition than a trade, if that makes any sense.
My mom and I used to go out every Tuesday with the church to hand out sandwiches to the homeless. You'd call that family tradition of sorts.
Oh, so you go to church?
No, no, not me, but my mom did. Weird thing about tradition.
Yeah. We should probably get going.
Yeah, lead the way. Holy shit. Okay. Lead the way.
How about some more?
Oh no, I better not. I should probably get something in my stomach before I go embarrassing myself.
Oh, man of moderation. How quaint.
A man of caution at best.
Well, then we better get the main course out here post-haste. Lassiter!
The groundsman?
And my husband. Not known for the spring in his step. Oh, not a moment too soon, dear.
Don't let the state of the grounds fool you. Lassiter is actually a very good cook.
If looks are anything to go by, I'm sure you're right about that.
Oh, you've outdone yourself, dear.
Good.
Delicious, thank you.
We usually like to say grace before we eat.
Stop it, Lassiter. Brandon is our guest.
No, it's my fault. I should have waited. Sorry.
No, it's okay, honestly. I never wait either.
I love furniture like this. Hand-carved, cared for, meant to stand on its own against the fine china it's holding. Furniture today is so painfully pragmatic. Built to sell, to get by. But furniture like this, and for something more. It's timeless.
How profound.
No.
Oh.
Simple observation.
Are you an artist?
Musician. My mother made me play when I was a boy, and she never stopped making me.
Oh, that is so sweet. Did you get your artistry from her?
No.
I'm sorry?
Well, you didn't get it from your mother. Well, what I mean is, when I was working on her for the funeral, I just didn't get the impression that she was artistic. There were no paint traces underneath her fingernails, or no calluses on her palms, and no scars or wounds to indicate any past or present labor. I just didn't get the feeling that her hands were altogether very artistic.
She sang. Never in public, but always to me and when she thought she was alone. She had a beautiful voice.
Time she flows, a maiden of mien. Her breath the lives of men, forever she'll be the end of he. Faith, hope, and love abide, but her breath doesn't stop until she solves the riddle of his mother, his lover, and he. Her breath she'll breathe, never to hold, always the cold.
Oh, that is absolutely lovely, Fiona.
Some dinner.
I wouldn't mind, Lassiter. See enough dead bodies and you're bound to loosen a bolt or two. Are you gonna be at work tomorrow?
No. No work tomorrow. I have to go my mother's house and sign some papers for the bank before they can start the estate sale. Turn over the keys and whatnot.
It's awful. You must have so many memories there.
Yeah, all of them, actually. Been there since I left the hospital, day one.
Have you had any help through all of this?
Little. I have some extended family I've never really known, and they sent an aunt of mine out to play diplomat. She tried. Really rather handle it on my own.
Could you take something? Something to remember her by?
Yeah, I'm still in the house for a few more days, but I've never really been the sentimental type. Taking a piece out of the house would taking a piece of her, without the whole thing.
You'd be surprised how much you can forget over time. A memento might not be a bad idea, but I'm sure you'll find your own way to remember her by.
You're very kind, Fiona. Your whole family. Even if Lassiter hates me in my agnostic ways.
Well, I guess he'll just have to get over those, won't he?
I hope I'm not around enough to find out. I mean, I just meant this being a funeral home and all.
Right. Of course.
Fiona.
Hello, Lassiter.
How are you feeling?
I'm fine, thank you.
No, I meant, how are you feeling about the...
I know. I'm fine. Actually, I think I'm gonna go for a walk.
Would you like some company?
No. Thank you, though.
Fiona, I wanted to speak with you. I have some things on my mind I'd like to talk about.
I think I know exactly what's on your mind. And just like the last time you had those thoughts, I don't wish to entertain them. So, if you'd please.
Hand me your glass, and I'll fill it up. I'll tuck in my tail like a scolded dog. I'll line up my pins for you to knock down, and I won't make a fuss while you tear up the town, and give me time, give me peace. Give me patience. Won't you please let me sleep? I'm a sea. I'm a sea. I'm a sea. I'm a sea.
Beautiful. Oh my God, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to frighten you.
No, it's okay. I just thought I was alone.
I like taking walks through here sometimes to clear my head. And I thought I heard you, so I thought it'd be polite to say hi. That's really beautiful, Brandon.
Thanks. It was her favorite. So, can't get enough dead people back at the mortuary?
Well, while they are a good reminder of how fragile we are, a walk out here beats doing yoga in the mortuary any day.
There's a joke about rigor mortis I'm missing out on here.
Yeah, I'm gonna pretend that it landed.
Thanks.
Oh, I didn't take you as a smoker.
Didn't take my mom for one either.
That was hers?
I had no idea. Found it in a drawer next to a Bible and a special box.
Was there anything else in the box?
Yeah. It was a personal device. The kind that requires
batteries.
Oh. Oh my God, wow.
Yeah.
No way.
Hand to God.
Oh, that must have been really weird.
It was a little strange. It's just so surreal. So much I didn't know about her.
Everyone has secrets. They just become truth when there's no one left to keep them.
That's some deep shit.
Well, my sister tells me that I have an old soul, so...
She's not wrong. And your advice about the memento?
I took it.
I'm glad. Hey, how have you been since everything happened?
Honestly? Not great. Turned in the keys to the house this morning, and so I'm sleeping in a hotel, which is fine. I just never not had my mom. And now that she's gone, can't seem to let anybody else in. Push my aunt out as soon as I possibly could, and I've been having these dreams. I just don't feel like myself anymore. Yeah.
Dreams?
They just started. And I'm hanging myself in the same place that she did every time. And I get up there. I look down. And I can't help but think, you've done it. I could never. She left me alone. She didn't even leave a note. She left without saying goodbye. That's what kills me.
Brandon, hey. She would have wanted you to know how much she loved you.
I should get going.
Oh, are you sure? I can only stay if you need.
Oh, no, it's fine, Fiona. Thank you. See you around.
What's the matter?
I think I've made a mistake.
Oh, my sister. My sister, that doesn't sound like her.
The dreams are preventing him from healing. He's not ready for this life.
Does it change the way you feel about him? Because it's a little late to turn back now. Hey. No one ever said that this was going to be easy. He's alone. He needs a soft touch to consider what to do next. Not someone with doubts. And at this point, you need him far more than he needs you. So stay the path.
Kat, is it really worth it? You and Lassiter are so unhappy.
We have an arrangement. But you... Oh, you have a chance at so much more. And every day being with you is worth it. Every single day.
No, you're right.
I know. I know. I love you.
I'm sorry, Kat. I love you too.
What are you doing here?
Well, funerals can be difficult, so I at least like to check up on the families and make sure they're doing okay. And go the extra mile.
Well, you have gone many more miles than necessary, Fiona, so thank you.
So, how does one get in the 21st century train business?
That's a good question. Well, I am my father's son, if you can believe it. He died when I was little, and the very same job I do now.
So you like trains when you're little too, then?
No. No, I hated them, actually. It scared me shitless. I'm telling you. Thomas the Train is one thing, but you're a toddler and your dad takes you to the front of that thing. The engine. It's a totally different experience. It's loud. I hated loud.
Do you remember him well?
Not much more than that. It smelled like engine grease. How do you do that?
What?
Get people talking. I mean, I haven't felt much about my dad one way or the other in years, and here we are trading secrets.
Ooh, I don't know if I'd exactly call this trading random.
You're right. Your turn.
Well, you know how I feel about secrets.
I suppose I do. Listen, just got on my lunch break, and it's a pretty scenic overlook. I like to eat my sandwiches, if you'd care to join me.
Okay. I didn't grow up here.
No? I thought the funeral business was a family tradition.
Oh, it is. Just came a long way off to inherit it.
Uh-huh.
It's true.
So where's a long way off?
All over. I moved around a lot as a kid.
World traveler.
Exactly. Never really got to know my father. Katerina says it's for the best. My mom, She passed away recently. But it was her time.
What about the funeral home?
It was at Uncle's. We took over for him when he passed on too.
That's so weird. I don't remember you or your uncle ever owning that place.
Well, you know what they say. Best not to get too cozy with a funeral director.
You're not wrong about that.
It actually used to be a butcher shop about 100 years ago.
No.
Yeah.
It's terrible.
Yeah. Oh, God, please don't tell anybody about that. We probably would be out of business pretty quickly.
I don't know about that. You must have another way of putting food on the table if you're just handing out funerals on a whim.
Yeah, we'll figure it out. They never change, but they always take my breath away.
The mountains?
Sometimes I like to think that we've already died and this is it.
Heaven.
Sure. Wherever.
Some thought.
You don't think it could be true?
Where do we go after we leave here then?
Maybe we just get to start over. From the beginning. With everyone that we've ever loved.
Maybe.
I like to think of the first people I get to see, my mother and father.
I'd be like heaven to me.
No.
are you doing here? Lassiter, no.
Take it. Take it!
This has to stop.
Katerina hates me.
You made your choice.
You don't know what it is to be hated or to be used. You only know love and loss. I have love for you, and I will make it so that you never lose it again.
You're a psychopath.
Love is...
No. You're pathetic. Not love. You. You spend so much time watching me, but do you know what you are to Katerina? A glorified lawn gnome. Your life is the sorry price of keeping her alive. And you're too much of a coward to do anything else. You always could have left.
Love doesn't work that way.
I don't love you.
Thank you.
What do you want? Can't this wait until tomorrow?
Why won't she love me?
Because she's better than you, that's why. Get your hands off of me. You wouldn't dare. You're a rat with a gift, nothing more.
Something.
Okay.
I had a lot on my mind. I know if I don't tell you now, whatever you decide, I will respect your decision.
What is this? You clean?
She's not dying or anything.
Not exactly. That song that I sang at dinner, do you remember it? There's a bit more to it. I'll spare you the serenade, but it boils down to the secret of eternal life.
I don't... What?
Okay, you know, the sooner that you realize that I'm not kidding, the easier this is gonna be.
314 years old. And Katerina and Lassiter are even older.
Fuck you.
Shut up and listen to me.
Okay.
The song presents it as a riddle. My sister and I and our husbands figured it out. You need to eat to live. You have to eat your mother, your lover, and part of yourself. And then you live forever. After that, anyone will do. But you have to have the flesh of man, the breath of time herself. And then you never age. Ever.
Wait. Wait. Back it up. You were married?
That's what you got from all of this?
I'm sorry, it's just, it's the only thing you said that made any sense.
I was. And he died.
I'm starting to see some holes in your story.
Anyone can break the song. When he killed himself, he started aging again.
And why would he do that?
I don't know. But the song requires a lover. Time lives alone. So to beat her, you can't. Without another, I can't go on living.
So you and...
John.
John, right. And Katerina and Lassiter, then? You all got together and ate your mothers and each other, and now you're just kicking it around the countryside ever since? where do I come in?
I started aging. I need another. And he's... I love you.
So you thought, Fiona, this is insane. I don't know what you're trying to pull here. It's crazy. Last night was great. The biting thing, that was a little weird, but I went with it. Now you're just talking nonsense.
Those dreams, they're getting worse, aren't they? And that song that's stuck in your head. Brandon, it's already started.
You're fucking insane. Fiona, I didn't eat anyone.
I'm sorry, Brandon.
For what?
The dinner. You.
I what? What did I do, Fiona? What did I do?
You ate her. And me. Brandon, please, okay? Brandon.
Stay the fuck away from me.
No, Brandon, no! Brandon!
minute, wait.
How do I stop it, Fiona?
You won't have an appetite for anything else. But if you eat, then it'll stop. I'm sorry. I don't know why I felt so drawn to you.
You barely fucking know me!
My dearest Brandon, I love you so completely. You are my only pride. I no longer want to be a burden. My beloved song. So many of my mistakes are yours. I have kept you to myself for too long. I owe all of the happiness of my life to you. Don't be alone. Marry someone you love.
Hello, Brandon. Careful now, or I may slip. Life is so precious a thing. Fickle, tenuous, a little bit this way, a little bit that, and you may just end one. I'd say that death is what I'm most afraid of, but really it's the not knowing that gets me. Even so, there are worse things than taking a life, and that's ruining one. You ruined mine. She loves you, and not me. And you don't even want her back. Don't worry. It's nothing essential. Thinking.
Why not end it all if my never-ending life is ruined? And to that I say, stick with the devil you know. Now, my life is ruined, and you're on my table. And I had to think, what would be worse for you? The dark uncertainty of death, or my curse? A never-ending life of pain, the woman you don't love, and a stupid fucking song. Should I kill you? Or just shove a piece of your own kidney down your throat and into Fiona's dinner? I have to be honest. I flip-flop on the matter a bit until I came up with something better. I'll make you choose.
I love you, Brandon.
Get away from him! Get away from him!
She flows, a maiden of mien, her breath the lives of men. Forever she will be the end of me. Always the cold.
do you love me?